Martin JTG up to some of the Usos' tendencies.
Well, if I were dating Tamina, I wouldn't really be discussing the tendencies of the Usos. I'd be doing things with their going to movies, dinners, things of that nature, baseball games. Jimmy Uso in control here of JTG, the flyest superstar in all of WWE.
Do you know what that means?
Fly? Yeah, it's cool, hip.
Except what you say.
Along those lines. Take down there by JTG.
Oh, mocking the
Siva Tau.
The Siva Tau, which is the war dance that the Usos do to prepare themselves. It has a great heritage, so that's an insult.
And you were telling me earlier that you think there's tremendous upside to both Jimmy and Jey Uso.
Oh, yeah, and I like the Usos. I call them young money. They're like the hot new young celebrities, like Logan Lerman or Asher Book or Stephen Strathy, these hot new young guys that all the girls are clowning around about. I also like the way the Usos greet their friends. It's like, what up, Us? Kind of makes you feel cool.
Yeah.
They greet you that way?
Yes, they do. Actually, Us means brother.
Brother, bro, what's going on? Can I say to you when I see you, what up, Us?
Just turn the other way when you see me. Oh, JTG turned the other way. And Jimmy Uso, a lot of people say that Jimmy's the more powerful of the twin Uso brothers. You have an opinion on that?
Either way, I find both Usos to be extremely proficient inside the ring, whether it be with powerful maneuvers or high-flying ability or just in-ring skillship. You like that soundbite?
And JTG sidesteps Jimmy Uso here.
The WWE superstars are in the midst of a very successful and exciting European tour, and I've just learned that exclusive photo.
Oh, hang on a second here.
Tamina providing somewhat of a distraction there, and JTG taking full advantage. My point was there are exclusive photos on WWE.com, some good action shots, as well as photos of the superstars mingling with the WWE universe.
JTG. Into the cover here, Jimmy Uso able to escape. And let me ask you, man, are you surprised at the budding relationship between Tamina and JTG? You seem to be the only person on NXT that's not dating anybody
that you know of.
Holler.
No, I'm not surprised at all. You know, again, it's all about opportunity. And anytime you can link up with someone just to get more camera time, it works for me. I mean, I'm sitting here with you. You ready for Survivor Series?
I am. Very ready for Survivor Series.
New York City, that's home for us.
I'm sorry, what was that?
New York City, that's home for us.
It is.
Madison Square Garden, completely renovated. That's one of the things that Survivor Series you're not going to want to miss.
Oh!
All your friends are going to be talking about it, and you're going to be left out if you miss it.
JTG, another cover here on Jimmy Uso, who powers through it, too.
I'll put you on the spot right now. You want to give me your picks for the three top matches that everyone's talking about? First, I'll start with Alberto Del Rio and CM Punk for the WWE Championship. Who do you like?
Well, all right, if we're going to have this
I'm
debate,
sorry, I asked you an analytical question.
That's okay, that's fine. I would rather discuss the comings and goings here of NXT, but you know what? I'll take CM Punk.
Why?
Oh, I don't know, Matt. I didn't expect to be quizzed out here tonight. I was coming here to NXT to have a good time with my old friend Matt Stryker and call some action and have fun, and now you want me to break down the WWE Championship match.
It's either that or we can discuss the disadvantages of JTG's footwear, which you'll roll your eyes at me for.
I have
so
no
I'm
problem
trying.
Discussing that. I actually like the Timberlands that JTG wears.
Why?
Because they're cool, and JTG can use those to his advantage.
You don't need to shout at me.
Oh, look at concern on the face of Tamina as Jimmy Uso looking to take over here. Has Uso done enough to put away JTG?
Well, this is where some of Tamina's advice may help JTG.
How so?
She can, you know, perhaps whisper something, you know, maybe, oh, he's got a bum left knee, or, oh, he doesn't like being poked in the eye.
Oh, great counter there.
I mean, who really does?
JTG.
But, you know.
Another cover, lateral press, Jimmy Uso down. I am just so excited for our main event here tonight, Johnny Curtis and Derek Bateman against Percy Watson and Titus O'Neil. Nice roll through there by JTG, who's been just one step ahead of Jimmy Uso.
Oh,
not so fast.
The alley oos. That could have cracked a rib. And this is where the Usos excite the WWE Universe, paying homage to their ancestry. Jimmy Uso ascending the top rope.
JTG three quarters across the ring. No problem for Jimmy Uso.
What up, Oos?
Well, the look on Tamina's face tells the whole story. Tamina obviously has aligned herself with JTG, a budding relationship. But it's Jimmy Uso who gets the best of the Maulin superstar.
Well, a back and forth match until Jimmy Uso comes crashing down on the chest of JTG, knocking all the wind out of JTG. And it only takes 3 seconds for victory here in WWE. You want to throw a what up, Uso out there?
What up, Uso? An impressive victory for Jimmy Uso here against JTG on NXT Redemption. It's still to come. Well, it's our main event. We've been talking about it throughout much of the night. Johnny Curtis returns to NXT, teams up with Derek Bateman. Sort of a love triangle going on there. Can they put it together and take down Percy Watson and Titus O'Neil? Our main event is next.
Leading to his safe return.
We're gonna need guns.
Kill them both.
Leo, huh? Don't blow yourself up. I see the future. You're not in it.
Own the DVD and Blu-ray only at Walmart.
Place in Liverpool, England for the first time ever in a very exciting tag team in Titus O'Neil and Percy Watson all set for action here tonight.
Well, all eyes are focused on the Survivor Series, and WWE Survivor Series is presented by WWE 12, the video game. It's in stores November 22nd, but if you pre-order now, you can receive an exclusive playable character of The Rock. Sounds pretty cool. Josh, are you in the game? Good talking to you, John.
Their opponents, accompanied by Maxine, at a combined weight of 466 pounds, the team of Johnny Curtis and Derek Bateman.
So sort of a tawdry situation here between Derek Bateman, Johnny Curtis, and Maxine. Betamax are engaged to be married, but we found out earlier tonight that Johnny Curtis, the winner of NXT Season 4, actually went on a date with Maxine.
Well, Johnny and Derek are friends, and friends share.
No, Johnny said that he's not friends with Derek Bateman.
Oh, well, friends still share.
How are Bateman and Curtis going to coexist here tonight?
Well, Johnny Curtis likes to call himself the professional. He feels he's above NXT. He doesn't belong on a quote-unquote rookie show. Yet the irony is, Johnny Curtis, you are on NXT.
And they're the object of desire for both Curtis and it appears, Bateman and it appears Curtis, Maxine.
Well, I almost feel bad for Derek Bateman, you know. He and Maxine are engaged for 2 weeks. They've already registered for their wedding.
Where did they register?
They registered at Saks, Dick's Sporting Goods. They're registered at Hooters, Long John Silver's. They're registered at the Crab House and the Come and Go gas station.
And Derek Bateman looking to gain control here. Nice takedown by Percy Watson. Percy Watson is just an explosive individual.
former professional football player, has the athleticism, has the charisma. Percy Watson does.
And you can see Watson opted to stay in the ring here with Johnny Curtis. Outside leg is hooked. How embarrassing would it be for Johnny Curtis, considering what you talked about earlier, that Curtis feels he's above being here on NXT, to lose to these two rookies in O'Neal and Watson?
Well, I've watched Titus O'Neal now for 35 weeks, and he is an impressive physical specimen with a ton of charisma.
And the powerhouse with the cover here. Curtis just slips out at two.
Your thoughts on Maxine?
I like Maxine. I don't have any issues with her, so I can...
But honestly, I mean, all kidding aside, Maxine's presence at ringside can certainly benefit Derek Bateman and Johnny Curtis.
Cover here by Percy Watson once again.
Well, I mean, some may find Maxine a distraction, but she happens to be a very shrewd and talented young lady and knows what works.
Well, to that point, how has the relationship between Maxine and Derek Bateman helped Bateman's career as Watson goes for another cover here?
Well, listen, love can lift a man's spirits. That's number one. Number two, it's given Derek Bateman confidence. And then that's extremely important here in WWE.
And Percy Watson made the mistake there of taking his eyes off of Johnny Curtis.
See?
And to all the arguing that went on earlier between Curtis and Bateman, they seem to be on the same page here tonight.
Well, you have to wonder how the news that we found out of the
cover here
at the top of the show that Johnny Curtis and Maxine went on a date, albeit innocent or not, can affect Derek Bateman's psyche. Have you ever been involved in a love triangle?
Yeah, I guess I have.
And how did it affect you?
It really has a negative effect on an individual. I'm sure it's weighing on the mind right now of Derek Bateman.
No matter how well Johnny Curtis does, if Derek Bateman is a jealous kind of guy, all he does is look at Johnny Curtis and go, ugh, you dated my fiance.
Johnny Curtis doing his best here to put away Percy Watson. Johnny Curtis grew up just outside of Boston, Massachusetts.
No, we won't hold that against him.
He's actually orphaned and spent much of his youth in an orphanage, Matt.
Really?
Another cover here.
Normally that would garner some sympathy, but the fact that Johnny Curtis still has no respect for anybody just tells me he hasn't learned anything from his life experiences. But I do like his La Parca-esque elbow bump.
No one knows who you're talking about.
I do, and several other people.
And Derek Bateman now.
But I do like the way that Bateman and Curtis are isolating Percy Watson, keeping Percy away from Titus O'Neil.
Potential submission maneuver here by Derek Bateman. Bateman, who's been very impressive thus far on this season, Matt, of NXT. He left and came back. Is that the story with Bateman?
Yeah, Derek Bateman went away, tried to recollect his head, and that's something that we've often known about Derek Bateman. He's a little sketchy, a little dodgy upstairs. You know, he's temperamental and sometimes has confidence in
him. And since his return, how would you rate the progress of Derek Bateman?
Well, he was progressing well. He was here for about a couple of weeks, and all of a sudden he laid eyes on Maxine, fell in love, and now you can see how well Derek Bateman's doing.
And here comes Johnny Curtis. Here comes Titus O'Neil.
Let's not forget that Titus O'Neil told Johnny Curtis, I may be a rookie, but I'm a rookie that will knock your teeth down your throat. And right now, a very angry Titus O'Neil is in full effect.
Titus O'Neil heating up here on NXT, taking it to Johnny Curtis. Cover here, Bateman sensing defeat.
And let's not forget, these are still rookies. Ooh. Titus O'Neil took his eyes off of Derek Bateman, and that's the only reason Derek Bateman was able to save this matchup.
Titus O'Neil doing everything he can here to say keep his composure, but unbeknownst to the referee.
Whoa, total elimination, high, low, could this be it?
And Bateman keeping Watson at bay.
Oh, I'm impressed.
So much of what we talked about throughout the night match, would Johnny Curtis and Derek Bateman sort of self-implode here because of the feelings towards Maxine? It didn't happen here tonight.
Well, I think that Derek Bateman's desire to show Maxine that he is the real man in this triangle may serve to benefit this tag team of Johnny Curtis and Derek Bateman, albeit inadvertently.
For anyone who wrestler's ever had girlfriend issues. We don't have to explain to you what is going on here between Derek Bateman and Johnny Curtis and Maxine. Bateman, they got the victory, but not really all that happy.
Well, either way, the question remains, what happens next on NXT?
Thanks for joining us. Good night, everybody. We'll see you next week right here on NXT.